A main event, one fall to a finish, from Abruzzi, Italy, weighing 245, Ilio DiPaolo.
In the western New York area, there is one name that is synonymous with wrestling, and that name is Ilio DiPaolo. On November 8th, 1926, Ilio DiPaolo was born in the small town of Introdacqua, Italy. From an infant, Ilio was primarily raised by his mother along with his younger sister. And at an early age, Ilio helped his mother around the house after school, but soon began working on some of the nearby farms to help contribute to the household. Life was very simple, but difficult. Farming was the main industry in the hills surrounding Introdacqua. Ilio worked hard on the farms to help support his family. So hard, in fact, that a choice had to be made when he reached the fifth grade. The nearest school was in the next town, which was too far for him to walk to. And that was the end of Ilio DiPaolo's formal education. Ilio's love for wrestling became more than just fun. At 21, he traveled to Venezuela, pursuing a career in a new sport, professional wrestling.
I went down there and I asked for a promoter and I challenged anybody in the island, wrestling, boxing, weightlifting, do whatever they want to do. You know, I challenge them on my business in wrestling.
Interestingly, Ilio's bouts included a match against top 10 boxer Emilio Argamonte. In the third round, Ilio pinned Argamonte and became the only professional wrestler to defeat a boxer at that time. One year later, a promoter saw Ilio wrestle in Venezuela and brought him to the United States. It was August 1951. From there, he gained respect in the wrestling world and his career continued with much success. Ilio's personal life soon became a success as well when he met Ethel Martinez. With Ethel's help, Ilio then obtained American citizenship, and they began to raise a family. Ilio DiPaolo's professional wrestling career continued until 1965. He achieved eminence in single and tag team competitions, traveling to New York, Canada, Hawaii, and Japan. During his lifetime, he held the world tag team title for 2 years, gained tag team honors for the All Asia Championship in Japan, and later competed with world championship distinction in Toronto and Winnipeg. Ilio also embraced the family of wrestlers he had come to know and love.
When we traveled and wrestled in Canada and on the way back, My hometown is Niagara Falls, and of course after we got back was early in the morning. Those are days to remember, really, what kind of fun we used to have. Stopped by my house and my mother, and God bless his soul, my dad. They would come out with the big super sot and the prosciutto, and the good times we used to have is about 2-3 in the morning. We used to drink up a gallon of wine and eat up all that salami and the supersada and the Italian bread and sing a lot of songs.
In his own family, Ilio wanted his wife and children close to him, and they often traveled with him to many of his matches. With the DiPaolo children, Dennis, Barbara, Michael, and finally Lisa, wrestling soon became secondary, and Ilio DiPaolo retired in 1965. But Ilio DiPaolo was not destined to be a has-been. A long-time dream had sparked his ambition to open a small pizzeria restaurant in that same year.
We started with a cook, a waitress, a pizza maker, and I stayed there. Well, we washed dishes, we mopped at night, and we had a lot of beautiful people that came and helped us through because we knew nothing about the restaurant business.
The early years, I remember when the restaurant was just a small pizzeria, and they used to make the sauce. And this man would make the sauce and he would sleep in the front office and then go back and stir the sauce, go take another little nap.
Ilio DiPaolo had started something beyond what he could ever imagine. Soon, Dennis and Michael were helping in the restaurant, now called Ilio DiPaolo's Restaurant and Ringside Lounge. Mainly known locally for famous tomato sauce, Ilio's pleasant demeanor and warm hospitality brought the people in. With the effort and hard work of his family, he knew the establishment would grow. Ilio also knew what he wanted for his family. He wanted his children to have something he never had, an education. Though with the good comes the bad, and very sad death of his daughter, Lisa.
After Lisa died, you know, things, you gotta keep on going. You have a business and you gotta keep on going. And you have a different outlook on it than for the family, for the people, for every way of life. You look at it a completely different way. And that's why I think I got involved a little bit more. I got a different perspective about how important the family is, how important it is to help other people. And that's how I get involved with the Rotary more deeper and much more than I did before.
As a member of the South Shore Rotary Club, the Romulus Club, and other community organizations, Ilio DiPaolo has received various commendations and public recognition by many area clubs and associations for his activities as an outstanding citizen. Ilio is well known for his humanitarian efforts to many charitable organizations, such as the Leukemia Society, the March of Dimes, and Camp Good Days, just to name a few. Events such as an annual celebrity golf tournament, wrestling tournaments, as well as many other fundraising activities, are sponsored by his restaurant. Ilio DiPaolo does not discriminate when it comes to giving when someone is in need.
Ilio has been a tremendous asset to the Rotary Club. Through his actions in our club, we're able to do events for the community that raise a lot of money that go back into the community in the forms of charity.
14P Blue.
And of course, football is a large part of Ilio's life.
He makes a point to go around and see all the people in the restaurant. And I shook hands with him and like just totally enveloped my whole hand. I mean, you know, I have a big hand and here this guy is, you know, I mean, he's massive in size and then his hand, his handshake is like shaking the hand of a bear or something. I mean, he's huge.
He's one of the most warm, sincere individuals I've ever known. He's friendly, he's a lot of fun. One of the most gregarious people I've ever known, and it's sincere.
Ilio Paul DiPaolo is a man who is now living his dream. A tremendous wrestling career, a wonderful family, and a thriving business built from ashes. Without substantial education, his knowledge and life lessons have been basically self-taught. The hard work ethic he subscribes to is very much his own, and he has learned that success does not come easy.
In my town, in Tradacqua, there was only a fifth grade schooling in my little town, and behind that, it was impossible for me to go because I couldn't afford to go. I was out of town to go past the fifth grade, but as it was, it's all I took, and that's not enough for anybody today to start a business. I was lucky that I had an exposure through wrestling and so on that opened up a lot of doors for me when I needed help to start the business. But today, to start the business today, you know, remember that was 30 years ago. To start the business today, if you don't have an education, forget it. And we are lucky here in this country. In fact, I wish I was born in this country. And I could go right down here, walk right down Hilbert College, is right down the street from me, you know. And that's what you need. You need an opportunity to learn something, and I did not have it.
Ilio DiPaolo will never forget his youth and the land from where he came.
Let's listen as Randy Weiss introduces the contestants.
From Buffalo, New York, weighing 258, the Blaisdell Pizza King, Ilio DiPaolo.
From Abruzzi, Italy, weighing 200.
245, Ilio DiPaolo.
From Buffalo, New York, Ilio DiPaolo.
Now let's get to wrestling.
Ilio DiPaolo, 250 pounds, equally fast, knowing all the wrestling holds. A wrestling classic right here.
Body scissor by DiPaolo. Good one.
But I have no fear for Ilio DiPaolo. He's a very clean, upright young man.
Ilio DiPaolo, Hans Schmidt, tag team with Dick Brower, teaming up with Hans. And Bruno Sammartino in the corner, Billy. Oh! He missed. Oh, and DiPaolo didn't miss.
Here comes Ilio DiPaolo into the ring now.
The bout is now officially underway with an airplane spin.
Sammartino just did.
It's a great favorite of Ilio DiPaolo. He uses those ropes as a little extra leverage to bring down his opponent.
Now he's got some extra action going here. Ilio DiPaolo and Johnny Paul.
Look at this. What a lift. What a lift. The airplane spin. If he got him, if he can hold him up there. 340 pounds, ladies and gentlemen, and Ilio spun him around, and that should be all for Man Mountain. That's it. We'll be back with more action in a moment right after we hear this message.
This is Dick Meyer here at Interview Time, and I have with me a very popular Italian star who has appeared in Montreal recently, Ilio DiPaolo.
Reverse the procedure now. He's got command. He wants to give him a karate or a judo chop, and that's what he's doing.
He won!